those middle rows, a lot of these methods don't get to. And we're going to talk about a proper cleaning method that not too many people really probably know about yet, and we just learned about it like 4 years ago and have seen it in action for the past 4 years and have been very impressed. But some of the people who are on this call, I know, are people like our sponsor, for instance. These last four bullet points, we're talking about feedback and building management systems. We've been on jobs where we've had equipment operating and we call a remote building automation system operator and to ask them a question, and they say, why are you asking this question? That piece of equipment's not on. We did that with a 1,000-ton centrifugal chiller one day, and he said, that chiller's not running. It's like, well, yes, it is. We're standing right here. No, my computer says it's off, so therefore it's off. And that's the kind of an attitude that you get with a lot of these remote operators because they don't have the feedback. But that was 5 years ago. Today, there's a lot of feedback in these building management systems, building automation systems that do these last three things, including our sponsor. The fault detection and diagnostics, automatically repair faults when you can. The software is out there to look at what's going on in the system and actually fix it from a remote location or from the software that's in your building. And it tells you. And it can tell you what all these various faults are that haven't been fixed. You got the green lights, the orange or yellow lights, and then the red ones that say, hey, you really got a problem here. You better go take a look at it. These are all the kinds of things that we look at. But really what it boils down to is proper and effective operating and maintenance procedures. So think about this. You've got one electric meter for your building, and the electric bill comes in, and you see that you had this horrendous spike 20 days ago. But you didn't know about it then. This is what some of these systems will do, like Brightbox, for instance. They'll tell you that something has gone wrong, or there are many, many software systems that do very different things. Some of them just gather information and give you that information on a relatively continual basis. But there are others that can actually dig in and drive down and perhaps tell you what's going on. But it's very difficult to do when you only have one large electric meter for an entire building. So we recommend when we're talking about new projects, absolute minimum, separate submeters for electric, for lighting, HVAC, and plug loads. But if it's a large system, you need additional meters for major equipment. If you've got a large chiller, you've got a couple thousand-ton system on a larger building with multiple cooling towers and multiple pumps and all those kinds of things, and you're in variable primary flow or whatever it might be, if you don't have some additional meters, you're really not going to know what's happening. So one of the things we kind of added to this was we want to talk a little bit about EPA Portfolio Manager Energy Star Analysis or this new ASHRAE Building Energy Quotient Labeling Program